Europe is facing many challenges. Create job opportunities for all, especially for young people. Get the economy back on track. Make companies more competitive in a global market. For solve the challenges of aging population. Secure resources like food and fuel. Fight global warming. Improve smart and green transport. Like you can see, these four items about socioeconomic questions. 5, 6, and 7 is a more environmental challenge. These challenges, Europe wants to fight with this strategy Europe 2020. It's not just for overcoming the crisis. If not, this strategy is thinking addressing the shortcomings of global growth model. Current growth model is not working. And then, with this strategy, European Union wants improve or change the growth model, more or less. For this strategy, Europe 2020 priorities, there are three main characteristics. First one, smart. I mean, more effective investment in education, research and innovation. Sustainable, environmental item, low carbon economy, and exclusive job creation and poverty reduction. These are the three elements for this strategy. This strategy has several legs. The most important for us and from my point of view is Innovation Union. I think this action packet is the most important, or at least is concentrating a lot of work currently. Innovation Union is a package, action package initiative for an innovation-friendly Europe. Europe's future is connected to its power to innovate. What about rural development? We have three strategic objectives from 2014 to 2020. First one, fostering the competitiveness of agriculture. Ensuring the sustainable management of natural resources and climate action. achieving a balanced territorial development of rural economies and communities, including the creation and maintenance of employment. These are the three long-term strategic objectives. This objective we can translate in six, like a kind of menu with six options. Each country must choose four of these objectives. Like you can see in this PowerPoint and in this slide, first and two and second are about innovation. Innovation is has a key role in this strategy. Fostering knowledge transfer and innovation in agriculture, forage, and rural areas. Enhancing the viability and competitiveness and promotion innovative farm technologies and sustainable forest management. Promotion food chain organization, animal welfare risks, restoring, preserving. These four, five, and six are about all rural development, but innovation is concentrating in first and second. Research, innovation, and agriculture. How innovation has changed in last years from green revolution to current model markets. If we find information in internet, we can we can find a special transfer effort with green revolution, transfer, extension or diffusion. We can say begin in green revolution. This green revolution refers to a series of research, development, and technology transfer initiatives. Spread technologies that already existed but had not been widely implemented outside industrialized nations, and technologies including modern irrigation projects, pesticides, synthetic nitrogen fertilizer, and improved crop varieties. Chemical fertilizer, pesticides, and herbicides, and really on machines was very important during the Green Revolution. After Green Revolution, we had oil crisis and debt crisis. This crisis supposed change role of public public work, public role, and then transfer, diffusion, and extension more or less disappeared, changed a lot. In some countries, transfer services, extension services disappeared. This was because structural adjustment programs during the 80s and 90s led to a significant decline in funds available, and then extension services changed and began. There was like a privatization. The main argument was extension services are not effective. Extension services didn't work. So World Bank FAO changed the concept, the role of these services. Family farming was the main victim. Family farming suffered as a result of this change. Currently, we try to go back to these kind of services, extension services. Every country in the European Union and even in international organisms are trying to create a new extension services, and the idea is now widely accepted that a new model of service delivery is needed. This should be pluralistic, with the private sector playing an important role. Demand-led is key. Extension service should be provided free of charge as smallholder farmers. This conceptualization, more or less, is opposite and green revolution thinking. In this context, we use currently acronym AKIS, Agriculture, Knowledge, Information, or exactly Innovation System. AKIS is based in System of Innovation, and Innovation System has seven functions. Firstly, knowledge development and diffusion, influence on direction of search and identification of opportunities, entrepreneurial experimentation and management of risks and uncertainty, market formation, resource mobilization, legitimation, and development of positive externalities. What a definition of AKIS? We can say AKIS is a set of agricultural organizations and persons in Green Revolution Extension Services were a service, a public service. Currently, we consider extension services like a system. Then the organization and persons and links and interactions between them are the key point of these extension services. Transformation, transmission, storage, retrieval, integration, diffusion, and utilization of knowledge and information with the purpose of working synergistically to support decision-making, problem-solving, and innovation in agriculture. But these words are similar in Green Revolution, but the main difference, I think, is we focus on people and organization. I think this is the most important element of AKIS model, from transfer, extension. When we talk about AKIS evolution, we can underline or highlight or three steps. In the 60s, we talk about agricultural knowledge system. This model, this system, are very, very near to Green Revolution in the conceptualization. Very top-down model. In 60s, AKIS, Agricultural Knowledge and Information System, maintain this point of view. Currently, AKIS, from Agriculture Knowledge and Innovation System, is a very huge change. Suppose a very huge change from research for research, innovation, and transfer. AKIS transfer model. The main characteristics are a pluralistic system with public and private service. Systems shaped according to country condition and based on lessons learned, redefinition of roles and tasks of stakeholders, public and private goods. Private sector goes for markets and funding, multiple sources of knowledge and innovation, decentralized, problem demand and market focus, extension of mandate for agriculture and rural development, horizontal collaboration and multidisciplinary teams, new funding mechanisms, client participation according to the capacities. If we compare these characteristics with... We can see what is the revolution. In 60s revolution was Green Revolution, currently we can say green transfer revolution, I think. The role of the stakeholders is more horizontal, it's not top down. Priorities, I'm very clever in Green Revolution. I was very clever and I imposed the objective for research. I imposed the technology, but with this model, farmers decide more or less what are the objectives of the research. They decide even the methodology with the researchers. How this is a problem for me. I would like to work in this line with research center, with fields, with companies. I think this is the key point for ACI's innovation system. In Green Revolution, science driving research, science works with these elements, but currently where innovation is working with these elements. For example, participation of users in demonstration phase and via research dissemination, but with ACI's agenda setting, defining the problem and during the research process. Quality criteria, scientific quality, and with ACI's model, relevance of the for the sector or region. Focus are research organizations, but with ACI's model, networks of producer and users of knowledge. Diffusion model, linear model, with ACI's model is more systematic system approach. I think about type of research interdisciplinary with absorption capacity in ACI's to work with material science and chemistry, but with innovation driving research, transdisciplinary and translational with close interactions. I would like with this PowerPoint that the most important objective for us, for researchers in rural development in agriculture, is innovation. But if you look in Google courses about innovation and agriculture, you can not find this kind of things. First of all, we have organized the first course of innovation here in Comunidad de Madrid, but our students are about all university people. We don't have agriculture. Innovation, about all in Comunidad de Madrid, is family farming, about all, need innovation. But farmers currently doesn't know. So we have a huge challenge for next year. If farmers, family farming in peri-urban areas, about all, doesn't get innovation, I consider family farming has no future. So innovation has a key role, research has a key role, but the methodology or the philosophy must be from ACI's point of view, not like a Green Revolution point of view. If we go back to Green Revolution, I think we doesn't get our objective. This is my point of view, my consideration. That's all. Thank you.